Well, a collaboration between Catalent and Johnson & Johnson means a future COVID-19 vaccine could be manufactured right here in Indiana. A Johnson & Johnson subsidiary has tapped the Catalent facility in Bloomington to be a manufacturing partner for its lead vaccine candidate. Business of Health reporter Kylie Valletta has the latest on a deal that could have major impact in Monroe County and beyond. Kylie, over to you.
That's right, Gary. A string of pharmaceutical companies is racing to develop a COVID-19 vaccine, including Johnson & Johnson. If the powerhouse earns approval on its lead COVID-19 vaccine candidate, it will be churning off production lines at Catalent in Bloomington. New Jersey-based Catalent burst onto the Indiana business scene 3 years ago when it acquired homegrown Cook Pharmica. The new vaccine deal will create 300 jobs at the facility. Dennis Johnson is general manager of Catalent Bloomington, and he joins me now via Skype with details. Dennis, thanks for being on the show today.
Well, Kelly, great to be speaking with you again.
Yes. So let's just do a quick refresher. The Bloomington plant there focuses on producing biologics, which are very advanced and complex medicines. What does it mean for this facility in Bloomington to land this kind of a prominent deal?
Well, we're really happy about this, you know, for a variety of reasons. One, it puts us on the front line of the fight against COVID, and we're really pleased to be able to do our part in it. I think we have a unique set of skill sets and capabilities that we're able to bring to the table and help that fight. And I'm also really pleased that Janssen has allowed us to make it public. When you look at the landscape, we're often not allowed to speak about the products that we work on. Catalent as a whole is large, with over 40 different plants, does over 70 billion doses. Most of the people do not recognize what's made by Catalent. So the fact that Janssen is allowing us to have the discussion is a great thing for our community and our employees to be able to speak publicly about this.
So tell us, what kind of work will take place at the plant if this vaccine candidate is successful, and what's the timeline for that work?
Sure. So the first part of it is we got to get ready. And if you manage, if the Colts were still playing right now, we're in the 2-minute drill, trying to speed up what we had last talked about. So Kelly, when you in our last discussion about a year ago, we had talked about being at 1,100 headcount and ramping up over the next few years to 200. Well, we're going to have to ramp up by 306 months. And we're going to have to finish the construction of the building and accelerate what we had planned on doing in the next year and do it in the next 6 months. So it's kind of like the 2-minute drill. We're really going to have to move faster.
So when will that hiring process begin? And give us your perspective on the local workforce there in Bloomington and its ability to support that.
Well, it's going to start very soon. When you look at the 300 headcounts, we are in the process of submitting the requisitions. They're going to get posted. We're going to start hiring in July of this year. Some of our jobs that are the more technical jobs have up to a 6-month training cycle. Our goal is to be ready for 24/7 operations in January of 2021. To get there, we're going to have to start hiring the longer lead time jobs, the more complex engineering and technical jobs, starting in July. And then we're going to continue hiring, and some of the simpler jobs may come in October, November, December, but we're going to start that 300 hiring in July.
And the Bloomington workforce, wide and deep there, you think, to help support that?
Well, it's a great workforce, and that's one of the main reasons that Catalent is here today. That's what differentiates us, and we've been able to ramp up things to the great local universities, whether it's IU, Purdue, Rolls-Hallman. There's great skill sets in the area, and really, Bloomington is a hub of the biotech industry if you look at the companies in the area and in Indianapolis. So I think there's a lot of talent in the area. And we've been able to ramp up, like I said, from our last discussion just over a year ago, where we were 1,100. We're well over 1,200 now, and we'll be 300 more in the next 6 months. So the local area can support that hiring, and it's a great area to be working, running a factory such as this, and because of the people in the area.
Okay, and Dennis, just a couple seconds left. You mentioned, meanwhile, you're also having to make some changes to protect your workforce there as they're coming to work each day.
Our workforce is our most important assets, and whether it's social distancing, masks, visitor guidelines, work from home policies, where a large percentage of our staff that can work from home do work from home. we're altering almost every aspect of our work and finding creative ways to do things, because we have to keep our employees safe. They are the heart and soul of our company. They are what's going to make the medicines that are going to help, in my opinion, have a large impact on the COVID crisis. So we have to protect them because we need them. We're very pleased to be able to do that and still support the manufacturing necessary.
Well, Dennis, thank you so much for being on the show. Good luck with that 2-minute drill down there in Bloomington.
Thank you very much, Callie. We're looking forward to it.
All right, Gary, back to you.
Big news.